to fall away. Now feel the wind blow outside my door. Meantime, I'm leaving my woman at home.
I'm speaking of a time when people become more and more evil, when their behavior becomes an abomination to the one true Father. I'm speaking of a time when we will be hated for the name of Jesus, for the name of Jesus, no other name. We'll be hated for Jesus' name. I'm talking about a time when food and water becomes more scarce. I'm speaking of a time when the power is cut off. I'm speaking of a time when you cannot trust your own family members. And this is here, and it's going to get worse. Like I said, it's a birth of evil that's going to happen. I believe the United States-led NATO coalition is trying to push for a war with Russia and its coalition, and I believe this is going to happen. Have you not pondered, brethren, why there is such a war right now on your Father, Jesus, and the 1611 King James Bible? Why? Why is there no war on Muhammad or Krishna or Buddha or all the other nonsense and lies of this world? Why is there no war on the Talmud, one of the most evil, if not the most nasty and vile book going? Why is there no war on the Quran? Why is there no war on the Hadiths? Why is there no war on the sacred writings, these old supposedly sacred and ancient writings of India, Hindu, Asia? Why just the 1611 King James Bible? Because it's the truth. Why is there a war on Jehovah Father? Because he's the one true God. All the rest are pretenders. Why is there a war on Jesus Christ? Because he's the real Son of God. Why is there a war on his name? Because his name is really Jesus and no other, and because his name has power. So what does your Father want you and I to do in these last days? What does your Father expect of you and I in these last days? What does he want us to do? Because the tribulation's coming, it's here, it's going to be the greatest tribulation known to mankind, and this will usher in the day when Jesus Christ will return for his children. So what does your Father expect of us during these evil days? Well, it's more than what he expects from us. We have to hear the message, but then we have to live the message. The first thing we need to understand is this: there is nothing, absolutely nothing, that your Father cannot do. There are no limitations on the power of your Father. Not one, man. Not a single nothing. You see, your Father doesn't answer to the evil of this world. They answer to him. And your Father gave all this power to his Son Jesus, who had glory with the Father before the foundation of this world. Friends, your Father wants us to call out to him in the name of Jesus. He wants you to call out to him. Call out to him. Your Father wants you to seek his face. It means to seek his attention, to seek his love, to seek his protection. Psalms chapter 105, verse 4 says, "Seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his face evermore. Seek his attention. Seek to want him." The words of Jesus Christ, Luke chapter 21, verse 36, "Watch ye therefore and pray always." So Jesus is telling us to watch and pray. Watch what? Not TV, not the internet, but watch for Jesus, that you may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man. Who is the Son of Man? Jesus. Psalm chapter 91, verse 4, talking about Jehovah. "He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler." His truth. But remember, everybody says his truth has been tainted, it's corrupt. God's word, they say, is null and void. Man, God's word is 100% true. Your Father wants you to do all this in the name of Jesus. Your Father wants you to pray. Your Father wants you to ask for his love and his blessing. Your Father wants you to call out the evil. Go to him and call him out. Don't be afraid to go to your Father and call out evil. Ask your Father to punish and condemn them. Your Father wants you to pray to him to give his time, his family time to prepare. Pray to him and tell him, "Father, give me a little bit more time for us, for your family, for your children, for our brothers and sisters. Give us time, Father, and put us where you want us to be." Pray to him and talk to him about it. Your Father wants you to do all this because he loves you and because Jesus loves you. Your Father wants you to do this because he answers prayers. Your Father wants you to do this because we are his children. He is our Father. He's not some distant relative. He's your Father. There's never been a moment in your life, not one, when your father did not know where you were, what you were doing, and what you were feeling. Not one, not a scintilla of a second that he did not know. And your father says, do all this in the name of Jesus, because God gave a part of himself to us in the form of a man that walked this earth. Now he's more than a man now because he had glory with the Father before this world was ever here. He is the image of God in the flesh. His name is Jesus. No other name. His name is Jesus. And our Father wants us to do all these things in the name of Jesus. Philippians chapter 2, verses 9 and 10. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. At the name of what? Jesus. There is no other name. I'm not even going to use the other names. It's Jesus. Your father can write. Your father can spell. Nobody can do it like him. It's Jesus. And if the world wants to call him 1,000, 2,000 other names because the devil has told him this is his other name, let him do it. You call him by his name, Jesus. When the devils came to Jesus and they fell down before him, they knew his name was Jesus. They knew he was the Son of God. They called him, you are Jesus of Nazareth. They knew who he was. Do not become emotionally invested in this world, for Jesus told us these things must take place. We are not of this world. Brethren, if we were of this world, the world would hear us. The world hears its own. This is why when you look at media, entertainment, and when you look at the people, they hear one another because they're of the same flock. They're of the flock of this world. We're not of this world. We're just passing through. 1 John 3:1 says, behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. The world does not hear us, brethren. See, the world does not know us because it didn't know Jesus. We're not of this world. In fact, the Bible says that if you have friendship with this world, is to have enmity with the Father. That means that if you love this world, you hate God. That's the thunder outside. The Almighty Father's talking. The Spirit of God is working, man. And we as his children have to get ready for the last mile, because it's right here in front of us, and I believe it's going to be soon. We have to pray. The world does not hear us. It's never going to hear us. But you know who does hear us? The Almighty Father and Jesus the Christ. They hear us, and we hear them. Remember, Jesus said he calls us by his name, and we hear him, and we follow him. It's intimate. It's personal. We are his loyal and faithful children, and we are called to be different during these last days. Your Father is expecting it from us. He is counting on you and I to be different. Different from who? Different from the world. Let us pray. Let us seek his face. Let us seek his love, strength, and protection, and we do it all in what? The name of Jesus. Let me say it to you again. Let us pray, seek his face, his love, strength, and protection. And we do this in the name of Jesus and no other name. Pray, my brothers and sisters, to love one another. Love your brother and sister because you are of the flock of Jesus Christ, man. Your kin, your family, you're related. How about we wake up every day and before our feet hit the floor, we tell the Father and Jesus that we love you, and let's talk about what we're going to do today together. Every second of every minute until the very end. In the name of Jesus Christ, let me say it again for you. Let's pray. Let's seek our Father's face, his love, his strength, and protection. And we do this in the name of Jesus and no other. In the name of Jesus, I thank you for watching. God bless you all.